Your Coca-Cola bottler presents Claudia, based on the famous play and novels by Rose Franken. Brought to you transcribed Monday through Friday by your friendly neighbor who bottles Coca-Cola. Relax, and while you're listening, refresh yourself. Have a Coke. And now, Claudia.
2 and 4 is 6, and 3 is 9. 2 is 11, carry 1. 1 and 8 is 9. Oh, that doorbell. Wait a minute, I'm adding. See now, carry 1 and 8 is 9. That's right.
Door was open, so I just walked in. Anybody home?
Yep, I'm home, Mr. Tucker. Come right on in.
I ain't interrupting anything, am I?
Oh, I'm glad you did. This checkbook is always wrong.
I just come over to borrow your phone, if I may.
Oh,
my confounded instrument went on the blink. I don't think they know how to build them right yet. Little bit of rain and out to go. And on a morning like this, wouldn't you know it had to happen, though?
What happened, Mr. Tucker? I mean, what else?
Me dang phone went on the blink just as Ruby's farrowing.
Who is Ruby? What's she doing?
Ruby's my prize pig, and she's having pigs.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so?
Where's that blamed instrument?
It's right over there.
Got to get hold of that veterinary. She's in bad trouble, and I can't help her now.
Well, now, don't you be so upset. Everything'll be all right.
She'd have to start when my phone went on the blink. It's kind of like they both knew the other one wasn't working proper, you know?
Do you know the vet's number, Mr. Tucker?
Yeah, I've got it right here someplace. Hello, operator. Give me Brook 480. Ring 1. You better bustle on it. This is an emergency.
Is Ruby having trouble?
Oh, terrible trouble. Terrible trouble.
Oh,
yep, Ruby's my prize pig. You can make a fat lot of money out of pigs like Ruby. Comes a fine line of pigs, sells your litter, and there you are. Ruby's like an annuity. Now she's gone and having trouble farrowing. Where's that dang vet? Hello, operator! Where's that number?
Don't be so upset. Just take it easy, Mr. Tucker. She's trying to get him for you.
I don't think she knows what she's doing. Them young girls ain't interested in getting numbers. They're sitting in their chairs gabbling with each other. Hello? Hello? This Dr. Graves' house? Jared Tucker here. Give me Dr. Graves. Give him to me quick, too.
Well, you make no bones about it.
He ain't there. Well, that ain't possible. He's got to be there. That's his office, ain't it? Gone up to Hartford for the day. What's he doing going up to Hartford? Never heard of such a thing. Well, I need him. I need him bad.
It's too bad you didn't know ahead of time, like I did when I was having Bobby. We had plenty of notice.
No. No point in Dr. Graves calling me tonight. You can tell him he's lost his job with me. What kind of a vet is that anyway, running up to Hartford on a day like this?
Don't get excited, Mr. Tucker.
Don't get excited? Don't get excited? Why shouldn't I get excited? My phone, my pig, my everything.
Well, surely you know another vet in the neighborhood. What's the name of that man who lives down by the nursery, the other side of Eastbrook?
Oh, him. I never used him.
Oh, I'm sure he's very good if he's in practice up here.
I don't like no new fellas around. He's a Pennsylvania man.
Ruby won't mind.
Well, guess this is enough for an emergency.
Here's his number, right here in the book. Dr. Wood, Eastbrook Center, 28, ring 4.
Operator, give me Eastbrook Center, 28, ring 4. You better see that line ain't busy. I ain't got all day, I haven't.
I hope Ruby will be all right. I can imagine how she feels.
Well, she better be all right, or I'll sue Dr. Graves all right going up to Hartford. I'll sue the phone company, too. They ain't got no right letting my phone go in the blink. Persecution against pigs, that's what it is.
Does Dr. Wood answer?
He ain't answered yet. I don't think I like him. He's too slow.
Well, they'll answer.
What's that, operator? He don't answer. Oh, the line's busy. Okay, yes. I'll wait for your call. But make it quick.
You just sit back, Mr. Tucker, and Dr. Wood will call you.
Sit back. Take it easy. This ain't right.
Look, if Ruby's such a wonderful pig, she'll manage.
Persecution against pigs, that's what it is. I don't know why everybody says pigs ain't sweet or they ain't clean. Pigs is the cleanest animals in the world.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on it.
Give a pig an opportunity to take a bath and he'll take it all right. Pigs just look dirty because folks like to keep them dirty. Makes folks look clean to have a dirty pig around. That's what it is. Pigs can be pets, too. That's Ruby. What a lady.
I'd like to meet her sometime.
See that you do. You'd like her. Say, where's that nice mother of yours?
Well, I'm not sure Mama'd be flattered by you speaking of Ruby in one breath and her in the next. She's in New York for the day.
I'll give her my respects. She's a fine lady, too. Phones never ring when you want them to. Obstinate critters.
Well, stop staring at it. You're scaring it to death.
Is that your husband out there in the field?
Yes, that's David. He stayed out in Eastbrook today because this afternoon he has to meet with the school board about the new school building.
Oh, I ain't questioning his being here. Eastbrook's a good place to be. But who's that there walking across the field with him?
Oh, well, that's Fritz.
Oh, so that's him.
Mm-hmm.
Your new man, ain't he?
Fritz and his wife, Bertha, they came up to be with us. She cooks, and Fritz is a wonderful farmer. We're very lucky to have them.
I hear say around town they're foreigners.
Foreigners? They are not. They're only from New York, like us. They're originally from abroad, of course, but, well, that's a long time ago.
They don't have to be from abroad. They can be from New York, and they're still foreigners.
Are we?
You was. Ain't there enough local talent around here for you to be using on your place?
Frankly, we haven't had much luck with local talent.
Well, don't know as I like it. This land's been farmed by my family and my ancestors and my friends and my relatives for well nigh on to 200 years. Don't know as I like this here Fritz coming in here with his foreign ideas.
Fritz and Bertha needed us. They were in trouble. We were very glad to help them out, and we're glad to have them here too, Mr. Tucker. They're fine people.
Maybe they are. But that ain't got nothing to do with it. You ain't been here so long yourself that you can start looking around and bringing in more outside.
Well, we use Dr. Barry. We use your carpenters. We have the same trouble you have with the local electricians and plumbers and contractors and so forth, so I don't think you have much right to
say. Well, you use everybody else up here, so you could have gone whole hog. Oh, what's the use in arguing when the pig's in trouble? What's happened to that dang operator? Has he decided to take a vacation now?
Oh, there he is.
What did you say that doctor's name
Dr.
was?
Dr. Wood.
Hello, Dr. Wood? Oh, it ain't you, hey? Well, give me Dr. Wood. Jared Tucker here. He ain't there. Well, that can't be. He's got to be there. Went up to Bridgeport to deliver a colt. What's he doing with the horse when Marubi's farrowing? You can tell him for me. I won't call him up again, I won't. Well, the medical profession ain't got no sense of honor, no sense of responsibility.
I'm sorry, Mr. Tucker, but... Well, maybe this isn't as much of an emergency as you think it is.
It's worse than it is. If something happens to Ruby, well, I ain't just thinking about myself, Mrs. Norton. I'm thinking about her.
Of course you are.
Claudia, balance checkbook yet?
Come in, darling. Gerard Tucker's here, and he's in trouble with his pig.
Oh, sorry to hear that. Anything we can do?
I'm over to borrow your phone, but quite no use.
Mr. Tucker's prize pig is following. I mean, farrowing, David, and she's in trouble.
No vet around. It's all part of this here pretty juice against pigs. Yes, that's what it is. That's what it is.
I think I have a person who can help you out, Mr. Tucker. We were just talking about raising pigs this morning.
Who's that?
My new man, Fritz. He's quite a hand with animals.
I don't trust no foreigners.
Do you trust us?
Well, you ain't lived here in Eastbrook very long, but...
How long does it take to be an insider?
At least 20 years, darling.
Oh.
We could be from Bridgeport and still be outsiders. It's nothing against Fritz.
Well, it better not be.
To be an Eastbrooker, you have to have lived here, died here, and then live here again. Then you are an insider.
That ain't what it said.
Oh, it's exactly what you said. I'll get it. Maybe it's one of the doctors calling back. Hello? Yes, he's here. Oh, Miss Tucker, hello. Oh, dear. Well, yes, of course, I'll tell him right away. Goodbye. That's your sister. She says your phone's fixed. You better hurry back. She says Ruby's weaker.
There ain't a dang thing I can do to help her. I don't want to go back there and just watch her.
Mr. Norton, I would like to...
Oh, excuse me, please.
Just a moment, Fritz. Well, Mr. Tucker?
Well, comes a time when a man's got to have a break with his convictions. And this here's the time, I guess. Mr. Fritz, you're no friend of mine, but... Mr. Norton here says you got away with pigs. Now let's prove it. Come on.
Yeah, that is all. 8 little ones.
Well, how is she, man? How is she?
She is fine now. We helped her and she's fine. She's feeding them, too. She is a little tired, but don't worry, that's good.
Great day in the morning, what a time we've had. Don't mind saying I'm tired myself just watching.
Fritz, that settles it. We're going to have to get some animals on our place. You have a way with them.
Well, it was nothing more little pigs I have brought into the world than you can count.
That was one of the most exciting, the most beautiful things I've ever seen. Birth of new life. Ruby was so patient and brave, and 8 of them. Say, Ruby's a much better woman than I am.
Sure, she's all right now.
Yeah, look at her. She smiles.
You know, I think she does.
She does.
Oh, Ruby, you sure put a fright onto me acting up like that.
Well, it happens, even with the best of pigs. You know, a Ruby is a very fine animal, Mr. Tucker. You must be very proud of her.
I love her like my own mother. God rest her soul.
I think that of all the animals, perhaps pigs are the most interesting.
I think they're fantastic. Look at those little piglets. They're born absolutely complete. Are all other animals like that?
No, pigs are much more complete than the others.
A baby lamb is very wobbly at first.
And I saw a new calf once. She looked like a woman with too much mascara on.
My Ruby had a fine litter. Yep, these pigs going to bring me a good lot of dollars, are.
Oh,
yep.
I don't know how you can bear to part with any of them. Look at them, walking around on their tiptoes. Just like little fat old ladies whose shoes are too small. Oh, they're adorable.
Yeah, they are sweet. That Ruby, Mr. Tucker, she has fine quarters and a good long back.
I picked her up myself at the Danbury Fair last summer. Yep. My lid onto her and I says, that's my pig.
You know your pigs, Mr. Tucker.
Yes, indeed I do.
Well, I think now we can go home, eh, Mr. Norton?
No, sirree, you don't go home yet. It's near time for lunch and Delilah's cooked up a rhubarb pie to celebrate. Fritz, I would consider it an honor of you to break bread with us.
Well, Mr. Tucker, I... Don't...
I ain't a man for speeches, and ain't a humble kind of man either. I've lived too long, and I've managed too well. But I got to say, you got a fine hand with pigs. Ruby knew you was her friend right off.
David, you said it would take 20 years.
With people. With pigs, 20 minutes.
You can learn a lot from pigs. I have. So, Fritz, I just want to say this. Any friend of Ruby's is a friend of mine. Shake on it.
I will shake on it.
Speaking for the community, welcome to Eastbrook, Mr. Fritz. Welcome to Eastbrook.
Are you expecting anyone over this week? Don't dismiss the whole thing until the last minute, unless, of course, you put in a good supply of Coke today. With plenty of Coca-Cola on hand, you don't need to keep asking yourself, what'll I serve them? The answer is right in your icebox, an answer that appeals to everyone. The ever-welcome way to bring the pause that refreshes.
Hello there, Mr. King. Hello there.
Well, congratulations, Mr. Tucker. I understand you're grandfather to a litter of piglets.
Well, tain't nothing at all. Tain't nothing at all.
And congratulations on something else, even more important.
What's more important than Ruby's litter?
We're happy you like Fritz.
Oh.
You see, we've known him longer, and we're all very fond of him.
Well, he's a good hand with animals, and it is sort of convenient to have a man like him around, so I welcome him.
His wife, Bertha, is as fine a hand with babies as Fritz is with piglets.
Well, then the Nortons really is lucky.
They really are. And Claudia will know it more than ever tomorrow. Till then, so long, Jared Tucker.
I'll be seeing you, Mr. King.
Every day, Monday through Friday, Claudia comes to you transcribed with the best wishes of your friendly neighbor who bottles Coca-Cola. So listen again tomorrow at the same time. And now this is Joe King saying au revoir. And remember, whoever you are, whatever you do, wherever you may be, when you think of refreshment, think of Coca-Cola. For Coca-Cola makes any pause the pause that refreshes. And ice-cold Coca-Cola is everywhere. This broadcast of Claudia was supervised and directed by William Brown Maloney. And now here's a word from your friendly neighbor who bottles Coca-Cola.